For ethnographic research, it concerns cultural group. It doesn't only mean na dapat dun sa mga tribo-tribo kayo, but the emerging definition of ethnographic research is that if a group of people shares similar culture, even though they are not considered as a tribe, so pwede ninyong gamitan ng ethnography. The aim is to get a clear understanding of the organizational setup para malaman nyo kung paano ba ang galaw sa loob ng isang organization, the internal operation, and the lifestyle of those members of a particular cultural group. Now, if your intention is to reveal the nature, the characteristic of one's culture through the world perception and through the information given by other cultural members, so pwedeng gamitin ang ethnography. Dealing with ethnography, you as a researcher should immerse yourselves within the culture. Ibig sabihin talagang pupunta kayo doon at makikihalubilo. If you will recall the discussion about observation, it could be participant observation or full observation or full participant ang ginagawa for ethnography. Data are collected during field work. If we say field work, ito yung time na kayo ay pupunta doon sa research site natin kung saan nandoon yung cultural group na ating ginagawa ng study. Now, this field work could be done through participant observation, through interview of the key informants, as well as through documents na available. Now, if you can notice, hindi lang iisa ang pinagkukunan ng data dito sa ethnography. Pwede sa observation, pwede sa interview, and pwede sa document analysis. And then, researchers observe the rules and rituals and try to understand the meaning and interpret the rules and rituals na meron dun sa iniimbestigahan na cultural group. But again, take note, hindi ibig sabihin cultural group ay as in ang pwede lang dito ay yung sa mga tribo. Ano, as long as a group of individuals shares the same culture, understanding such culture could be applied under ethnography. Now, in ethnography, aside from having interview protocol, you shall use field notes. Now, these field notes are written throughout the field work kung saan sinusulat ninyo yung mga bagay na nakikita ninyo, na-observe ninyo for a particular observational unit. And the main evaluative criterion sa isang ethnographic research is you'll be able to present the culture as experienced by its member. Again, the aim is, kung gagamit kayo ng ethnography, dapat ang research objective ninyo ay maipresent ang culture ng isang grupo. However, it's not that easy to conduct ethnography, especially if you will be dealing with those under indigenous group, kasi kailangan ng necessary permit with government agencies concerned para mag-conduct ng study with regard to the culture of an indigenous group of people. For ethnography, here are the features of ethnography. First, focus on how culture sharing group works. You should describe, interpret the shared and learned pattern of values, behaviors, beliefs, and language. So ito yung mga ini-investigate sa ethnography: values, behaviors, beliefs, and language. And of course, ethnography involves engaging in extensive fieldwork. So if sinabi natin extensive fieldwork, hindi lang iisang araw kayong pupunta doon. Pagka nag-ethnography kayo, talagang may times na doon na talaga kayo halos tumitira. And then for ethnography, it should develop cultural interpretation starting from the emic perspective, then comparing to the ethic perspective. If we say emic perspective, it's within the group's perspective. First is you start with the emic perspective. Emic perspective is within their own perspective, and then you'll be comparing it to the ethic perspective or the perspective outside the perspective of those within the cultural group. So in that manner, nasasubstantiate ninyo kung ano bang meron dun sa cultural group na yon. Again, this is the feature of ethnography. Ito yung mga aims niya. Before mag-decide kung bagay bang ethnography, make sure na ma-address itong mga features na ito. Okay? How you will do the ethnographic research? So first, of course, here are the procedure. Identify muna kung bagay bang ethnography. And then, if okay, sa aims of ethnographic research, identify nyo and then locate ninyo yung cultural sharing group. this study, you should be able to identify who is the key informant or the cultural gatekeeper. If you say key informant, it's the one who knows how the group works. So, ito yung dapat yung ma-interview. They are also called as cultural gatekeepers. Sila yung mga elder dun sa lupong yan. And then, after identifying your local and your sample, you select the cultural themes, the issues, or theories to study about the group. Should identify ano ba yung pag-aaralan within such cultural group. And then, next, you determine which type of ethnography to use because there are varying types of ethnography pa rin. And then, gather information through fieldwork, the one that we've discussed earlier. And then, observe bounds of reciprocity, access, and representation. If you see reciprocity, meron ba siyang katumbas pagdating dun sa iba? Access, sino lang ang pwede? And then representation, sino ang or ano ang ipinapakita ng ganong instances sa cultural sharing group. And then collect and analyze description of the culture sharing and forge the cultural portrait as a final product. Remember, if your aim is ethnography, therefore your product should be a cultural portrait ng grupong yun. Or paano nyo ipepresent yung kanilang culture pagdating sa ethic perspective. Again, emic is within, then ethic is outside the circle. Okay, I hope that's clear. Similar with case study, meron din tayong challenges pagdating sa ethnographic research. First, need to understand cultural anthropology, meaning kailangan pang meron din kayong background knowledge or basic knowledge kung paano nagwo-work ang isang cultural or anthropological study. And then, it takes time to collect data because the fieldwork should be extensive. And narrative apply literary approach because there are instances na merong mga kasi part ng culture, yung mga paniniwala, yung mga kasabihan nila. So, may instances na yung ating narrative will not be as strict as other research narrative na nagiging literal. Okay? And then, the possibility that the researcher will go native and compromise the study. We say go native dahil nga nag-immerse kayo, yung na-absorb nyo na kung ano yung meron dun sa lugar na yon. Okay, for example, ng going native, let's say pumunta kayo sa isang lugar na may punto, tapos sa tagal nyo nakikihalibilo dun sa lugar na yon, namaman nyo na yung paraan ng kanilang pagsasalita. Dahil nga na-immerse na kayo. And then, sensitivity to the needs of individuals governed by existing laws and regulations of the land. Isa sa restriction ng pagkakandak ng ethnographic research ay yung mga existing law because the cultural assets ng isang lugar are protected by existing laws. Again, here's the feature of ethnography. Tingnan ang ating pinakong perspective pagdating sa ano dapat maiproduce ng ethnographic research, papaano kinakantakin ng graphic research, and of course, yung challenges ng ethnographic research.